Green and everybody's taking a wrap around dollar ticket. Be generous by you.
This way,
yeah.
And then you can tie that.
Oh!
Behind us.
Oh, nice. Back, boy!
keep the wind out, that's the main thing.
Alright, well, I'll go back down the other side.
Yep.
This one
there. Oh, I'm cutting some ropes, eh?
How's that, chick?
Yeah.
Improvement?
I love your makeup, Granny.
Thank you. this is magic. Oh, I reckon we might get Chick to move about 3 feet one way or the other shortly.
I agree with that.
Hey?
I'll agree with that.
So you said you didn't have any distortion on last week's call, Chick?
No.
I might borrow a tape off you at some stage just to take a dub off it, because our copy had a bit of distortion all through it.
Righto.
So, yeah. Or I'll just throw you this player and just get an audio dub.
Yep.
So we've got the station archives, that's all.
Okay.
We'll move it in a minute. I'll get everything organised shortly. Just hate being in a real rush like we were before. Yeah, I can push you on top of it too. It's easy. So that's good, Chick. Now I don't have to sort of lean to get around your camera to see the scoreboard.
Is that easier?
Yeah. TV, that'll go under. So here we go. Right, I'm going to do that. I'm putting the microphone. Although Bert's got one down there. Bert's got the other one down there, so we might be right, so that might be moving. Spanner and a bit of wire.
Is that what you were doing?
Throwing the bloody spanner up.
Yeah.
Friday morning. So I was all set up before we went to have a meal. I went to Sydney, right?
does it. It's funny that they like the difference in the style between the grades.
That's your offer, yeah?
Dollar doubles.
Dollar doubles in the A grade.
Before you get the next beer.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Dollar change.
Right.
Thank you.
sound at the moment, Chick, or is it?
Hey?
Have you got any sound at all at the moment, or is it just music?
I haven't plugged in yet. Do you want me to test it?
Should still be wind noise there, shouldn't there?
Yeah, I'm driving.
nice wind, yeah.
Is that
half-time?
That's half-time. The half-time score in retrograde, and we're leading Huntsford by 12 points to the federal.
The fellas will save them.
Thank you.
As per, and,
Grosgrove. Possible gas per. Aberdeen gas per up to 15. Now I told all of you, let you know who's 16 and 17. There will be. 1 to 15 to right, 16, 17. Hover around down the table, near the table down there. They'll have it for you. They should have it before the kickoff. I know what we're going to do about 10 past, quarter past 2. Not just for a bit of atmosphere, a bit of colour.
Plenty of insulation paper.
Gonna lose it for sure.
There's about 40 metres of the snow.
Thanks, my champion stuff.
We'll be right back. I'm going to take a leg up. 44 lead me, 6 plate Newcastle, 34. He was, I'll tell you what he was. Sorry, the distance thing, mate. I know that you're at 12.
Someone puts a shirt back on, that's about serious. I like your shirt, but I do my shirt.
good by Newcastle. And if Parramatta were to lose today, of course, Newcastle and the Sharks will have the next week off the roost. The Broncos will bow out Saturday at Football Stadium Saturday night. The Bulldogs will play the Warriors, with the winners will play Newcastle on Sunday at Football Stadium. Parramatta will play St George in the line. The winners will play the Sharks at the Football Stadium. 13-32. Is there a semi-final? They play the Warriors at Mike Dursley Green. College Campbelltown, Luke Westfield.
Four, big buddy.
Yeah. no magpies or something, is there?
Someone's had some fun.
Yeah, as soon as you cross to us, I'll be calling up because I don't want to stop playing you or the whole thing.
10 breaks, so I'll just offer the Lego Bag guy. While we're actually on here,
alright. Oh, there's Dan. See ya.
Well played, fellas.
Thank you. Dan Dillon. Thank you very much. Good afternoon. Welcome to McKinnon Field here in Aberdeen for the Group 21 Grand Final. Our game getting underway in around 25 minutes or so. We've just seen the conclusion of the reserve grade game, and Tim, a convincing win to the Merriwar Magpies in reserve grade.
Yes, Chris. Merriwar, too experienced, played safer football. Musselbrook had their chances but dropped it at vital stages. Merriwar deserved winners, a convincing win, and controlled the ball, and congratulations to the Merriwar Magpies, another town in Group 21 that we'll be celebrating tonight.
Absolutely, and of course repeating the news earlier, if you missed it, that Singleton running out convincing victors in the under-18s competition over the Denman side. Denman tried hard, but Singleton certainly just too good on the day.
Yeah, Singleton, a couple of class players in the back line, come back from A grade, and your 18s player of the year, and Riley Brown, your 18s player of the year, was young Craig Edwards, and Riley Brown, who has played for country this year, pretty classy in the back line. Denman put it up to him, but Singleton just too good on the day, and going to be a team to watch in the next couple of years, those boys, as they come through.
Well, I'm having a look down off to the south, Tim, at what the weather's doing. Last year, of course, on Grand Final Day, but the last couple of years on Grand Final Day, it has been very, very wet.
Yeah, we're not going to worry about water today, I don't think, mate. I think we might have a bit of breeze. The breeze is actually starting to drop off a bit now. But
it's been blowing an absolute gale here today. It has been absolutely arctic, the wind at stages today.
I just had a look behind me. The tarp behind us might have had something to do with the breeze not blowing as hard on our back.
Yeah, they've whacked that up since we were on here with the Grand Final preview earlier today. But let's go right away to the sideline for the Musselbrook District Worker Club and talk to Chris Lewis and find out how things are going on the sideline. G'day, Chris.
G'day.